The world has taken the brunt of the COVID-19 pandemic and is now trying to move into a recovery phase. We absolutely need to open our economy because poverty and prolonged isolation can also cause death. The problem is that if we don't do this carefully, we'll have a resurgence of the virus and we'll have to shut down all over again. This is the first 7 of 14 keys to the recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic. Hi, this is Dr. Shintani for your health. This is part 1 of 14 keys to COVID-19 recovery, including the first 7 keys. Number 1, median time of exposure to symptoms is about 5 days, with a low of 1 day to about 14 days at the longest. So when you see a big event, you'll see cases peak about 5 days later. Number 2, median time from COVID-19 symptoms to death is about 18.5 days. This is why when you see a big event and a rise in COVID-19 cases, you don't see a rise in the death rate right away. It takes a little over 2 weeks for people who have been exposed at a big event before they wind up dying and causing a peak in the number of deaths. Number 3, COVID-19 is not the flu. It is a SARS virus or severe acute respiratory syndrome caused by a coronavirus, which is different from a flu virus. Many scientists are now calling it the SARS-CoV-2 virus so that people realize that it is a SARS virus and not a flu virus. COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2 virus, when it is severe, causes severe respiratory distress and requires patients to be on ventilators. This is why you find hospitals being overwhelmed with COVID-19 cases in intensive care units and running out of ventilators, and you don't see this with the flu. Number 4, cytokine storm. One of the reasons why COVID-19 causes people to require a ventilator is that a cytokine storm takes place in some of the cases more often than in the flu. And what happens is you get a sudden drop in oxygen. And oddly enough, people don't feel short of breath right away. This is why an oximeter may be helpful in early diagnosis of COVID-19. See our other video to give you a fuller explanation of this phenomenon and why the pulse oximeter can be very important. Number 5, this cytokine storm is basically a massive inflammatory process that can cause severe lung damage. This is why anti-inflammatory medications used for lupus, such as dexamethasone, hydroxychloroquine, and supplements may be useful. A new peer-reviewed study at the Henry Ford Hospital showed a 50% reduction in mortality with hydroxychloroquine, while several other studies indicate that hydroxychloroquine does not work. The Lancet retracted the study that suggested that hydroxychloroquine was dangerous, and millions of people have used it without serious side effects. Number 6, case fatality rate for COVID-19 is decreasing, or more accurately, I should say, infection fatality rate. But it is not down to the level of the flu. The low estimate by the CDC for COVID-19 is now about 0.26% fatality rate. It is lower than previously thought, but this is still over 2.5 times more deadly than the flu, which is estimated at a 0.1% case fatality rate. Case fatality is slightly different from infection fatality because case fatality rate divides the death rate by the number of confirmed cases, where infection fatality rate divides the death rate by the number of estimated infected people. But don't be fooled by this low number. COVID-19's real danger is multiplied greatly because it is much more contagious than the flu. This is why wearing a mask or a face shield, washing hands, and physical distancing is crucial to our recovery. And don't forget that COVID is much more deadly with age and comorbidities, and even young people are now populating ICUs and ventilators. Number 7, Case fatality may be decreasing because of improved treatment of COVID-19. Over time, we've learned how to treat COVID-19 for better outcomes. For example, oxygen via nasal cannula and placing patients in a prone position early in the treatment seems to reduce the need for ventilators. In addition, medications given at the right time, such as dexamethasone, remdesivir, hydroxychloroquine, and zinc, may be reducing mortality. In my next video, part two of this series of COVID-19 recovery, I'll be talking about how we may be experiencing a resurgence of COVID-19 right now, and how it may be more contagious than we ever thought, and what to do about it. Please consider subscribing to this channel, click the bell for notifications, click the share button, and share it with at least two or three friends so they can spread the information too. This is Dr. Shintani for your health.